How does one celebrate Buddha's birthday? For one South Korean man, it's by doing on stage and playing electronic dance music. DJ New Jean's name has been captivating young audiences by blending EDM with the teachings of Buddha. His stage name derives from Sunim, a Korean title of respect for Buddhist monastics. And while not a real Buddhist Zen master, the largest sect of the Korean Buddhism has gifted a DJ with beads and a headset, asking him to keep spreading hope and happiness to the younger generation. U.S. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen warning of a possible strong Chinese response against tariff actions from America. Yellen's remarks come ahead of the expected Tuesday's announcement of President Joe Biden's new China tariffs targeting strategic sectors. This includes a major hike in levies on electric vehicles. Yellen says U.S. officials could reconfigure tariffs first imposed under former President Donald Trump to be more strategic. She noted, however, that any changes in these would narrowly be targeted. Yellen didn't divulge more details, though, of changes in U.S. tariffs on China, but asserted China would be informed before the new tariffs implementation. The tariff update comes as Biden tries to contrast his approach with that of Republican candidate Donald Trump, who has proposed across-the-board tariffs that White House officials see as too blunt and too prone to spark inflation. Philippine fast food giant Jollibee saw higher quarterly net income and revenue. The firm of Tony Tangkatkyong booked a net income of 2.7 billion pesos, while revenues were up to 61 billion. Meanwhile, net income of Lucitan Group was at 6.42 billion pesos in Q1, slightly higher than last year's 6.38 billion. This growth was driven by strong earnings from its banking and tobacco businesses. The Philippine National Bank contributed 46% of the total, while its tobacco business added 41%. And finally, Philippine 7 Corporation, which operates 7-Eleven stores in the country, reported a 21.2% growth in net income. Capitalizing on this growth, the firm aims to add about 450 7-Eleven stores this year to bring its total number to 4,000. The Philippines seeks to learn from the Netherlands in establishing a national food hub in Clark, Pampanga. A Philippine delegation, including officials from the Clark International Airport Corporation, visited Amsterdam last week to learn best practices from the second largest exporter of agricultural products in Europe. Dutch officials taught them the need to timely deliver the right product to consumers with the help of modern technology. Now, last year, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. gave the green light to the Trade Department's three-year food logistics action agenda, which includes the creation of a national food hub in Pampanga. Now, the 8.5 billion peso project aims now to be the country's premium wholesale market and distribution source of high-value and top-quality food products. A subsidiary of the firm behind Mega Sardines venturing into the powdered drinks industry, Mega Prime Foods announced it acquired Filipino instant coffee brand Jim's Coffee Mix, previously owned by Goldshine Pharmaceuticals. The value of the acquisition was not disclosed, but it was part of Mega Prime's food growth ambition for the next 5 years. The purchase includes the total portfolio of Jim's Coffee, including its manufacturing arm, equipment, and products in development. Now, Jim's Coffee Mix is known for providing added ingredients, including ginseng and agaricus mushrooms that have health benefits.